Good morning, student. Welcome to the class. Hope you all are fine and completed your work which I have given to you. Today I am going to take a new topic, chapter 2, flower, fruits and seed. Dear children, in this lesson today I am going to explain you about parts of flower and types of flower. This is the structure of a flower in which you can see all the parts of a flower. First is pedicel. What is pedicel? Pedicel is a stalk of a flower. When you pluck the flower, you pluck it from pedicel. It is attached with the stem. Above the pedicel, there is a part known as thalamus. This part is known as thalamus. On thalamus, all the four valves are attached. Thalamus is a swollen tip. Now, in that, sepal, petals, androecium and gynoecium are attached. Sepal means calyx, petal, corolla, androecium, the male reproductive part, stamen, and gynoecium, that is pistil, the female reproductive part. Now, children, we will run each part separately. Valves of a flower. What do you mean by valves, children? Valves means spiral pattern. Spiral pattern means making a circle. You always see flower is in a spiral form. So these all four parts are making a flower in a shape of a spiral. First part is calyx. Calyx means sepal. Then corolla. Corolla is petals. Androecium, the male reproductive part, and gynoecium is the female reproductive part. In class 5th also you have learned about the androecium and gynoecium. Now we will discuss it more clearly. First part, calyx. It is the first whorl of the flower. This part is a sepal, you are seeing over here, which supports the flower in the bud stage. Bud stage means when the flower is not bloom out, then it supports, it's covered the bud with a sepal. It's a green color leaf like structure. The second whorl of a flower is corolla. Corolla means petals of a flower. It's the most beautiful part of a flower. Bright color, beautiful smell by which we all are attracted towards it. We are seeing this flower is more beautiful. Why? Because of the petals. Its color, its design, its shedings. Now, what is the main function? The first function of corolla is to attract the insects or us towards the flower. The second important function of petals are that it protects the main reproductive part of a flower. Because we are seeing the petals, we are not seeing the main reproductive part. So petals hide this reproductive part inside their petals. Androecium is the third whorl or the male reproductive part of a flower. Androecium is also known as stamen, which consists of two parts, filament and anther. Filament are the thin hair like structure which bears the anther, in which, or a lob like structure in which pollen grains are there. Anthers is a small structure which contains the pollen grain. Children, now the last whorl of a flower, that is gynoecium, is a female reproductive part or also known as pistil. Pistil consists of one or more reproductive part or units which called as carpel. Carpel having three important parts, that is ovary, style and stigma. Ovary is present on the base of the pistil. Ovary contains small eggs or ovules which contain the female cell. Then children, style is the extension between the stigma and the ovary. Extension means wire, you can say it helps to connect two parts. Same style is helping two part, stigma and ovary. Then what is stigma? Stigma is a disc-like structure which help in pollination. When the insects come and sit on a flower having a pollen grain attached to it, this stigma suck the pollen grain and through the style transfer to ovary. Now student, you have understood all the parts of a flower. We go through a next topic, that is types of flowers. Types of flowers are of two types, complete flower and incomplete flower. Complete flower, in which all the four whorls are present. Four whorls, what are four whorls? Calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. Also called bisexual flower. What do you understand by bisexual flower? Flower present both male and female part. They are known as complete flower. For example, hibiscus, rose and sunflower. Incomplete flower. In this, any one part is missing. They are also called unisexual flower. Unisexual means only one part is present, either male part or female part. Means either androecium is present or gynoecium is present. For example, begonia and willow. Now student, I'll stop the topic over here and giving you some question you have to do in your copy. Questions are, question number 1, name the fourth whorl of the flower. What are the important parts of a carpel? The fourth whorl of the flower is gynoecium. The important parts of carpels are ovary, style and stigma. Question number 2, what is thalamus? Answer, the pedicel continues to form a slightly swollen tip called the thalamus. Question number 3, what is the name of the male part of a flower and female part of the flower? Answer, male part of flower is androecium, female part of a flower is gynoecium. Question number 4, it is a long question. Explain the structure of flower and its function. Children, whatever I have written about the parts of flower, each part I have shown you and written some points over there. You have to see it from the beginning and write it in your copy. Also draw a well-labeled diagram showing different parts of a flower. Dear children, in the beginning only I show you a structure of a flower. That is the parts of a flower. Full flower diagram you have to draw in your copy. Thank you, student.